friends. Ooh. I'm super excited about this video. But first, hey, how are you? I'm good. Thank you so much for asking. If you're just tuning in, this is off of the high from my first reaction video ever, which I also did to Sam Smith's How Do You Sleep? So if you haven't seen that yet, check it out. You all have been so incredible with your love and your comments, the likes, the subscriptions. It's so amazing to see friends that live in Brazil and Puerto Rico showing so much love. I wanted to say hi to all of you and thank you so much for your support. So today I will be teaching you the choreography for the chorus of Sam Smith's How Do You Sleep? And just as a disclaimer, this choreography is originally created by the amazing Parris Goebel, which you should definitely check out because she's incredible. So, are you ready to get started? All right, friends, now we're in class. Don't mind the outfits. Before you begin dancing, I would highly recommend that you stretch in whatever way that feels comfortable for you, just to make sure that we prevent any injuries. So the first one that we're gonna do is that nasty grinding sequence that Sam Smith did. When you start that, I want you to think about like if you were at a cookout or at a club and your jam came on, and that natural instinct that most people have to go, ooh, yeah, that's my shit. That's the kind of intention that you wanna have. You wanna think of your body making a snake-like motion. So you wanna extend the chest, roll it down. One to the right diagonal and one to the left. Next, we're gonna combine that with our legs. You will bring up your right knee in a 90-degree angle. So the roll will go like this. One. Now that we have the foundational snake-like movement, let me now give you the pattern that's within this choreography segment. It starts right, left, right, right. Then it switches to go the opposite. Left, right, left, left. Now that we have that part of the choreography finished, and I want to give you the last detail, which is putting your hands on your hip. Put your hands on it. When you get really, really into it, you look like the dancer that was in Sam Smith's video. You see what I'm talking about? He was in that. Do you hear me like? There's a little bit of a distinct detail with the second half of that eight count where we're going left first, five, six, seven. Then we're gonna bring this left knee down and then you bring that left knee and the right shoulder together towards your core. Eight, and once you have that, you can easily put your hands in. Now let's try to put that together. Six, you got it. Five, six, seven, hit it. One, two, double, three, four, five, six, special part. Five, six, seven, hit it. One, two, double, three, four, five, six, special part. Next part, fundamental movement that goes with this is pretty simple. The step and close, step and close. Starting with our left foot, we're gonna step towards the left. Step and then close with your right, close. Then we're gonna do the opposite side. Again, it's really important for you to put your own swag and your own sauce into it. With that, you want to have some kind of groove movement, whether it's a bounce or a glide, something that's going to give it that character. For this video, I will be doing a little bit of a bounce like this. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Now to the added detail. I want you to bring up your arms. I want you to actually imagine that you're holding a pole in between both hands. If somebody were to call your name to the left side of you, if you wanted to turn to see them, how would you turn holding a pole? Like this. When we step to the left, our upper body is going to twist to the left as well. When you bring together, your arms switch, still holding that same rod. From here, we're going to step with our right to do the next combination. And one, two, three. This is where it gets a little bit different again. Instead of doing this, what we're going to do, our left arm is going to come down. Our right elbow is going to come towards our center and our left knee is going to come in as well, like this. Boom. Then you can bring your arms right down. Ha! Just like that. Let's try that sequence again, starting from this step. Five, six, seven, eight. One, and switch, and three, and four, and good. Let's try it again. Five, six, seven, eight. One, two, switch, and one, two, hit, and good. Let's try that from the top really slow. five, six, seven, eight. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And one, two, switch. Three, four, hit, and five, six, seven, eight. Now, because I made such a big fuss about it in the video, we're all gonna get into our sexy by having our hands grace the side of our hips. So it goes, we're here. All we're gonna do, since the left leg is stepped out, we're going to step it in, bend both of our knees, and starting from our knees, come all the way up our hips just like this. So this is four, five, six. Then from here, we're gonna step with our right foot, arms going in the air, seven, left steps, and our hands come sleeping to the right side of our face. The pattern goes one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. The trick to this is, as soon as one foot lands, the other one has to come up really, really quickly. Starting with our left foot up first, we go one, two, three. Now we're gonna do the opposite. My right foot is up, that means it goes down first. One, two, three. Awesome, just like that. You're gonna do that for a whole eight count, okay? It goes one and two, three and four, five and six, seven and eight. So from four, we know that we go five, six, seven, close eight, and one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Excellent. Let's try that from the top. And now we're to the end. Woo! So we just finished our sleeping segment. By the time that we finish, our left knee is going to be up. So naturally, when we get to the next part, we're going to step out with our left foot. Boom. So have you ever seen two older black women dance before? Or maybe even seen them at church in the choir, and they doing that little one-two sway, but their butts be sticking out like this? Yeah, that movement right there. If you do this at your house, that's gonna help you with this next movement, okay? That rotation of your hips is actually what we're trying to look for right now. So you're basically gonna be making half moons with your butt. Starting with your butt coming from the right side and going to the left. So when we come here, we step to the left, boom, two. Then reverse it, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. So from here, six, tell me how do you, one, two, three, one, two, three. One, two, three, one, two, three, and a one, two, three, four. All right, friends, we're finished, so let's try it from the top. Get ready. Five, six, five, six. Tell me how do you do? I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial and that it was helpful for you in learning this choreography. If you have any more ideas of songs that have great choreography that you would love for me to break down and teach you, I would love to hear about it in the comments section. Friends, I love interacting with you all so much so, that I kind of thought about this idea. Anybody that records this and sends it to me, I will share your video on my Instagram and my social accounts to show the growing friend circle. For more of my original content and my personal story, you can follow me on my Instagram account at tgmt.tv. Friends, I had so much fun with you all today. This has been incredible. I can't wait to see y'all the next time. Until the next time, friends, be good, be safe, and always be yourself, because everybody else is taken.